हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. सो टुडे वी विल बी टेकिंग अप अ न्यूमेरिकल ऑन केबल्स विथ एंड्स एट डिफरेंट लेवल्स. लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन न्यूमेरिकल विथ केबल व्हेन दे हैड यू सॉरी पॉइंट लोड्स, राइट? देन वी टुक अप न्यूमेरिकल वेर इन द केबल हैड यूडीएल थ्रू आउट, राइट? एंड नाउ वी हैव अ केस वेर इन द एंड्स आर एट डिफरेंट लेवल्स. Previously, what two we did, that is point load and UDL, they were in the same level like this. So both the ends were in the same level, and now we'll be going ahead with cables at ends at different level. So this is the cable A, B are its two end points, end supports. Point C is this point. Okay. So because they are of different levels, so I'll have a H1 height, that is the su of support A, H2 of support B. Okay. Then length will vary, so I'll have a L1 and L2. The entire span is L, so I can write a condition that total span is going to be L1 plus L2, right? And this is H1 and H2, that is the height of the support from point A and point B. So we have seen the equations. I'll just make a note of the equations again. So H1, calculation for H1, that is height, is W L1 square by 2H. Similarly, H2 is going to be W L2 square by 2 times of H. Okay, so these are for your heights H1 and H2 of the supports. Okay, next we'll have equation for L1 and L2, that is the length. L1 is given by L into root H1 divided by H1 plus root H2. Similarly, L2 length will be given by L into root H2 divided by H1 plus H2. Okay, so these two equations are for the two lengths L1 and L2, right? Then after this, we have to calculate the VA and VB, taking the moments at A, B, or moment at C. We will be taking, and we will be finding the moment, not moment. We'll be finding the reactions VA and VB, right? After that, we have to find the H, that is the horizontal thrust, which is given by W L square by 2 times under root H1 plus under root H2 the whole square, right? So this is for the horizontal thrust. And once this is done, we have an equation for the length, that is the length of the cable, okay, not the span length. Capital L is length of the cables, small l indicates it is the span of the cable. So capital L is given by small l plus 2/3 of H1 square by L1 plus H2 square by L2. So these are the equations that we will be making use to find the or to analyze the cable with supports at different ends. So I will be writing the equations again. So with this, let us take up a first example. Students are still joining. Okay, so I'll read out the question and draw the diagram. A flexible cable weighing 10 newton per meter, that is the UDL, right? So because we are dealing with the loading type as UDL, so it is the UDL weight W is 10 newton per meter, hangs between two supports which are 50 meters apart, tells us that L is 50. Okay, 50 meters apart means L is 50. The left support is 8 meters below the right support. So if I have something like this, if this is B, right support, and this is A, the left support is 8 meters below. So we'll directly draw the final diagram for this. So something like this. This is your support A, this is your support B. The difference between these two is 8 meters. Okay, then below the right support, the cable also supports a point load of 1200 newton. So there is UDL we are aware of. So when we show the UDL, we usually draw a line and we show the UDL in this manner, correct? So UDL is given as 10 newton per meter is the UDL loading. Apart from this, there is also a point load of how much? 1200 newtons at 15 meters from left support. So this total is how much? is 50 given to us, 50 meters. So from here, at the distance of 15 meters means somewhere at this point. Okay, 15 meters like this. So at a distance of 15 meters at this junction, there is a point load of 1200 newtons. Okay, so here there is a point load. If it is not visible, like this. So the, apart from this UDL, there is a point load of 1200 kilo, sorry, not kilo, only newtons, right? So the positioning has to be shown properly. Then, and this load is 3 meters below the left support. So this is a left support. 3 meters below the left support means this distance he is giving. This distance is 3 meters. 3 meters below the left support. This horizontal distance is 15, correct? And vertical distance is going to be 3 meters from the left side of the support. Assuming that the weight of the cable is spread uniformly on the horizontal span, find the maximum tension for the cable that is occurring in the cable, right? So this is your final diagram. This is 15 meters. Now we have to analyze this diagram, right? So when we start analyzing the diagram, first we have to mark various points. Now, usually what we do is when this type of numerical come and there is a point load given, we also give you this y distance. This y would be the maximum distance, meaning it is assumed that these two are in the same line, right? So based on that, I'll have h1 and h2 now, correct? So first I will write for h2. H2 total is going to be 8 plus 3. Okay. So it is going to be 8 plus 3. That is how much total? 11 meters. And H1 is going to be how much? Only this distance. That is 3 meters. Right. I'll tell once again, I have to first find the H1 and H2 based on the given figure. Now, this depth they have given us 3 meters. So this becomes my H1. H1 is what? From support till the maximum depth. But here when they give us a point load, we'll assume this only. So this becomes your H1, which is 3 meters. What about H2? H2 is always from this point, no? It is 3 plus 8, that is going to be 11 meters. So H1 and H2 you will note down properly. Then L given is 50 meters, so we are aware of that. Now using this, let us calculate the individual lengths, L1 and L2. Now when I'm writing L1 and L2, so formulas are what? L1 length is equal to L into root H1 divided by under root H1 plus under root H2, right? Substitute here. L is 50 into root of 3 divided by root 3 plus root of 11. Please give me the value of L1.
L1 is 17.15.
Similarly, L2 will calculate. L2 is same. L into here you will have root H2 divided by under root H1 plus under root H2. So L is 50. Root H2 means it is root of 11 divided by root of 3 plus root of 11. How much is L2? Okay. This is your L1 and L2. That is when you add also this L1 and L2, you will be getting total as 50 only. You should get 50. It is, the equations are such that they're dividing the total length into two lengths, that is L1 and L2. So this is your first step where you will assign H1, H2, L1, L2, you will find using the given formula. Okay. Next, we have to find, second step is reactions. Right. So I'll have horizontal, I have vertical. So when I show them on the diagram here, I'll have a VA, I'll have a VB, right? And there will be H coming like this, HA and HB, or H also you can write. So now to find the reactions, first let us write summation F of Y equal to 0. Summation F of Y equal to 0, that is all the vertical forces. So I have plus VB, plus VB plus VA, minus 1200 and minus 10 is acting for 50 meters. So 10 into 50. Have you right? VA plus VB are going on top. Minus 1200 is your point load. Minus 10 into 50 is your UDL is equal to 0. So from here, I'll have VA plus VB equal to, this is 500 plus 1200, that is 1700 newtons. Okay, this is our equation one. That is VA plus VB is 1700 newtons. Now, when we are taking moments, now I have to call a point, you know. So what we'll do, we'll call this point only as C. We have to take moment at this point C. Okay, this is point C. I have to take moment at C. Now, when I'm taking moment at C, generally when I have same levels and say this is point C, so when I'm taking moment, whether it is left-hand side or right-hand side, it will be in equilibrium. But now because these both are different at different levels, heights are different, lengths are different. So the moments when we're taking, I have to take two times moments, moment at C, left-hand side, moment at C, right-hand side. Okay, like that. So first, I take moment at C, LHS, that is left-hand side. Left-hand side, mein what all forces are there? You will have VA, you will have H. Okay, the distance is L1 is going to be 17.15, like that. So I will start writing the moment at C from left-hand side. That is VA into, you will not take this 15. Right, 15 is the distance of your point load. L1 is different. Always remember, L1 is going to be, so when I divide this, so this is going to be L1 and this is going to be, it's not visible now. Here you will have L1, here you will have L2. L1 and L2 is totally different from your this 15. This 15 meter is telling me the position of the point load. We are not going to use that. So when I'm taking moment at C now, VA into L1 first. Okay. It is going to be VA into L1. It is going clockwise. Minus H into 3. H, I have pointed it out outward. So H goes to C in anti-clockwise. So minus H into perpendicular distances, 3 meters. Minus H into 3. Okay. Then what is there? There is a point load here acting, which goes to C in anti-clockwise. So minus point load is 10 newton per meter acting for L1 and moment is L1 by 2. So minus your 10 acting for 17.15 meters. I'm taking moment, so 17.15 by 2. Okay. And then I have 1200. So minus 1200 newtons into. Now where is 1200 acting? Here. And this is 17. If I draw only the beam diagram, so 1200 is here, 1200, this distance is 15, and our C point is 17.15. So when I'm taking moment of 1200, it is going to be 1200 into this remaining distance. What is that remaining? 17.15 minus 15. So 17.15 minus 15 equal to 0 is our equation. Okay. How many of you have not understood? Please tell me openly. I don't know, somehow I'm getting a gut feeling that you have not understood this equation. You want me to explain it once again?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay. See, this is your, I'll just draw that time being beside this. Something like this you have, right? So this is L1, this is L2, and this L1, we are assuming L1 is also at a distance of 3 meters only, and that beam will be looking like this, okay? And this L1 is here, that is, how much is L1? 17.15 is here, moment at C I have to take, no? And here there is a point load of 1200, okay? This is your VA. So when I'm taking, or VA is here. When I'm taking moment, VA into L1 first. So VA into L1. And VA into L1 goes like this, clockwise. So VA into L1 is with a plus sign. Then H I have shown in the free body diagram outwards. Right here, it is outwards. So when it is going to C, H will go to C in anti-clockwise direction. So sign comes as minus. So H into perpendicular distance is 3 meters. So minus H into 3. Okay. Then comes your loading. From till C, I have to take loading. So now we will shift to this beam diagram. So what is the UDL here? It is 10 newton per meter acting for 17.1. So when you have UDL given and you are taking moment at this junction, it is going to be W into L into L by 2, no? It goes like this. So W into L acting at the center into L by 2, it is going anti-clockwise, so it goes with minus sign. So same thing, W is how much? 10 into L is 17.15, that is 17.15 into L by 2 is again 17.15 by 2, and it everything goes in anti-clockwise direction, so it is with minus sign. Then remaining is your point load of 1200 kilonewton. 1200 goes to C again in anti-clockwise direction, so minus. Now the distance is this distance from C to the point load. How will I get? Total is 17. In that, this is 15 meter. Point load is at a distance of 15. So 1200 into that distance is 17.15 minus 15. Okay, equate it to zero. I hope you have understood, or you still have doubts, you want me to explain once again. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, I don't know the value of VA also. I know L1, I don't know H also. Whichever values we know, we will substitute. VA into L1 means it is 17.15 minus H into 3 minus, we will solve for this. Get this value, please. Calculator. How much is this? 10 into 17.15 into 17.15 divided by point divided by 2. That is going to be 1.47 into 10 to the power 3 minus this is 1200 into 17.15 minus 15. That is 2580 equal to 0. Correct? So now this equation, I will write it such that I will have only VA. So if I want only VA, so VA into 17, I'll keep on one side. This entire thing, I'll shift it that side towards the right hand side. So what it is going to become? This plus this, that is plus 1.47 into e to the power 3, that is 4050, these two, and minus 3 times of H, plus 3 times of H when it goes to the right hand side, and then I can divide this by 17.15. Right? If I want to write the condition for VA, you can write it like this, no? I will take these three terms to the right hand side, and only VA I want, I will put that 17.15 at the bottom. So this is your equation for VA. I will get one more equation like this for VB. Then I'm taking moment at same. Again, moment at C, but from right hand side. So now we have to write moment at C for RHS side. I will draw that figure once again separately here. RHS means this. Here you will have VB. Okay. This is your beam. I have to take moment over here. This is 10 Newton per meter. L2 distance is 32.85. Okay. And H into 3 will remain same. So now when I'm taking moment at C, okay, moment at C will be VB into this distance, that is 32. And VB is going to C in anti-clockwise direction. So minus VB into 32.85, first loading. Then H into, look at this, from here to here, what is the distance? Now this H1 was, or horizontal thrust made a moment with perpendicular distance as 3 meters. So similarly, this horizontal thrust is making a moment with C with a perpendicular distance of how much? H2. H2 is how much? It is 11 meters, right? So I'll have to write plus H into 11 because this H goes to C in clockwise direction. Okay, so plus H into 11, then I have UDL acting throughout here. So it is acting for a distance of L2, and this UDL will go to point C in clockwise direction. So it is plus 10 into 32.85 into 32.85 divided by 2 equal to 0. Only these many things. Look again, I'm taking moment at this point for all the forces which are there on the right hand side. So I'll have H into 11. That is horizontal thrust into 11, BB into this distance, this is going to be 32.85, and then I have this point UDL 10 into 32.85 into 32.85 divided by 2. Only these three are going to come. There is no point load. So now here, VB, I want to have an equation only on VB. So what I can do, I can evaluate these two and put these two other side and this on the other side and write an equation for VB. So this equation will further be simplified as 32.85 times of VB is equal to 11 times of H, because this is minus, it goes and becomes plus. 11 times H plus, what is this value? 32.85 divided by 2 into 32.85 into 10. It is 5.39 into 10 to the power 3. Okay, so this is right hand side. So what is the value of VB then? It is 11H plus 5.39 into 10 to the power 3 divided by 32.85. You get two equations of VA and VB, right? So once you get these two equations, I will use those two here. VA plus VB equal to 1700 is there, no? I will substitute into that and then try to solve. So I'll just erase a few things here. So VA plus VB was how much? 1700, no? And VA, we have got the equation directly. I'll substitute for the equation. 4050 plus 3 times of H divided by 17.15. This was VA. VB is 11 times of H plus 5.39 into 10 to the power 3 divided by 32.85 is equal to 1700. A plus VB equal to 1700. In this, what is the only thing that is unknown?
H.
H. So we have to solve for this equation and get the value of H. Now, how do we solve this equation? How can we solve this? How do you you tell me how? This is simple maths, actually, high school mathematics. But I just want to ask you because there should be some conversation also. So can you tell me how can I go ahead with this equation? How to solve this equation? Or can you try and give me the value of H? You want to use calculators and try? You can use calculators and try. You want to just do manually? That is also fine for me. I do not mind. But get me the value of H. And then I will tell you how to solve it. Or my way of... All of you take a minute and try to solve this, please. All of you trying? Yes, how are you going to solve this? Or give me the value directly, I don't mind.
Ma'am, 92.84.
H, you're getting 82. No.
92.84.
No. Have you solved? Others? This is simple maths, no? How are you going to solve this? Only x is unknown. Why are you so scared?
Ma'am,
7478.86. It is a 4-digit only, but not 7000. Answer is 2500.
2549.6.
2549, correct. Who is this? 0.6. Who?
Sadharma.
Sadharma, yes. Yeah, I get it. B division, ala. This is correct. How you did, Sadharma?
Direct calcium.
Calcium.
Direct using calcium.
This I have got from your generation, people, students, all of you. I've seen students, you all can directly make use of calculator if you all are not sure of how to do. You have in this year, silver color kind of calculator, you have a provision for numerator and denominator with one unknown, right? So directly you can substitute. Or mathematically, you students will be very strong at mathematics, I believe. Mathematically also, how do you go ahead with this? Simply you take, if you want, start with LCM. You would, these both are not common, 32.85 and 17.15. So what would be the LCM for this? This into this is going to be the LCM. Either I will take the LCM, multiply by one another. So here this entire equation gets multiplied by 32.85. This entire equation gets multiplied by 17.15, equated to 1700. Okay, this solve, right? Or the 17.15 is common for this also and this also. So 4050 divided by 17.15, you will get a value. 3h divided by 17.15, you get in terms of h. Plus 11 divided by this, you get in terms of h. This divided by this, you get a number plus. Okay, equal to 1700. Both numbers, take them together. Both h, you take them together. Then find for h. Now send the numbers, that's it, divide it. You will get the value of h, right? Is it that difficult? Either do it by calculator, or you can take LCM, or you can divide directly because you know the values. So you are getting a value of H equal to 2550, 2549 or 2550. Okay. So this is the value of H. Clear? So once your H, you want me to solve or you will do it?
We'll do, ma'am.
Try to do. Say you're not able to do, you simply ping me on WhatsApp. I will solve and send the solution. I don't mind. Okay, but try from your side. So H you're getting 2550 because it is high school LCM and stuff. Right?
Ma'am, 2549.38.
That's correct. Fine. That is also correct. 2549 means around only 2550 if you take also, is fine. No problem. That is also correct. So once you get the value of H, we have the equation. VA is what? 4050 plus 3 times of h divided by 17.15. Substitute into this. 4050 plus 3 times of 2550 divided by 17.15. Similarly, VB is what? It's 11 times h plus 5.39 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 32.85. Substitute for h value. 11 into 2550 plus 5.39 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 32.85. Get me the values of VA, VB, please.
Ma'am, VA is equal to 682.21.
21 newtons, correct. What about VB? Anybody got VB? Directly, you get to 7. Substituting this, it should be same as that, but still 1700 minus 680.1017.
Yes, ma'am.
Even if you substitute here, you'll get it approximately this. Even if you take 1700 minus, because VA plus VB is 1700, no, 17 minus this, I will be getting the value of VB, right? So this is your VA and VB. Any doubts with VA and VB? So this numerical with different support levels. More tricky part is your moment equations, because I take moment at C, no? LHS and moment at C, RHS. So if these two equations are correct, then you will land up to these two equations. And if they are correct, then you substitute, you will get the value of H, and in all are interconnected. So taking again here, what I want to stress is taking moments, first semester engineering mechanics, third semester strength of materials. Taking moments is very important. Whether you're coming from left side, whether you're coming from right side, the moment equation has to be correct or else everything is going to go into waste, right? So we got the values of VA and VB. I'll note the values of VA, VB. VA 682.25 newtons. VB, you got 1018.13 newtons. Okay. So once this is done, we have to find the maximum tension. Now, maximum tension, T max, occurs at point B. A and B, there are two points. So because B is at an upper level, maximum tension occurs at point B. So I will write T max equation. T max equation, we know the T max equation. It is V square plus H square. So here, because it is at B, so V value would be VB square plus H square under root. So VB is 1018.13, the whole square, plus H is 2550, the whole square, under root. What is the value of T max, please? We have a habit of writing kilonewton everywhere, so don't do that mistake. The question was given in newton, so it is newtons, right? This entire numerical, because he had asked us only for T max. Any doubt with this? Shall we take up one more? You'll be a bit comfortable. Okay, yes. We have 20 minutes time, and how much is possible we'll do in that. If it doesn't get over, then we'll continue in the next class, no problem. Right? So, yeah, I have not it circulated the notes for this. Today I do it on the group. Okay? So you can go through. Bhavikatti textbook also is fine. How many of you have textbook, by the way? You have any, you have structural analysis textbook? Yes, no? You can type if you don't want to talk.
No,
ma'am. Okay. I will check if I have a soft copy of the textbook, or I'll at least try to download, and I will send a textbook also on the group. Right? If I don't do it by today evening, one of you please remind me. I have a high tendency sometimes. I forget. Right. The flexible suspension cable of weight 0 kilonewton meter. Do I have to write this? No. It's okay. But they have given in the question. That is, a weight is 0 kilonewton meter, saying it is a negligible weight. Hangs between two vertical walls of 60 meters apart. So your L is 60 meters. Okay. 60 meters apart. The left end being attached to the wall at a point 10 meters below. And below the right end. So left end is below the right end by 10 meters. If these are my two supports, and I try to draw this line. So this is the right one. So the distance between these two is 10 meters. Okay. And this distance, total L, is 60 meters, small l, right? The left end being attached to the, okay. A concentrated load of 1 kilonewton is attached to the cable in such a manner that the point of attachment of the load is 20 meters from left hand at 5 meters below. So from here, at 5 meters below here, so this distance is 5 meters, okay? Then I draw the beam of this. So first of all, UDL will be there only, right? And here there is a point load. The value of point load is 1 kilonewton, and it is acting at a distance of 20 meters. 1 kilonewton is attached to the cable in such a manner that it is at a horizontal distance of 20 meters from left side and 5 meters below, right? Below the left support. show that the maximum tension occurs at the right hand support and find the value also of that, right? So these are the data that is given to us in this particular question. So next, to show the other things. So this is going to be VB, and I'll have a H over here. This is going to be VA, and I'll have a H over here. Now this is your H1, which is 5 meters, and this is going to be your H2. We'll calculate H2. That is 5 plus 10 is going to be 15 meters. Here somewhere I'll have a point C, and when I calculate L1 and L2, this is L1 and L2. It goes ahead like that. So wherever I've marked the point C, no. So this becomes L1, and from here it becomes L2. L1 and L2 from point C. So when we start solving for this now, loading is not given. Okay. Self weight of the beam is given. Sorry, I missed it. There is a self weight of the beam. The flexible suspension cable of weight 0.0075 newton per meter is mentioned. Meaning there is self weight of the beam. 0.0075 newton per meter. Okay. So I thought it was only 00. So that is there. And then so that means this UDL is 0.0075 and this is the point. Okay. Shall we start solving? So for this, first H1 is 5 meters. H2 is how much? It is going to be 5 plus difference is 10. That makes it 15 meters. So H1 and this total will be H2, that is 15 meters. Next, let us find L1 and L2. L1 equation is L into root of H1 divided by H1 plus H2. Okay. And L2 is L root of H2 divided by root of H1 plus root of H2. Substitute and get me the values here. L is 60, under root H1 means 5, divided by root of 5 plus root of 15. And L2 is L is 60, under root 15 divided by root of 5 plus root of 15. What is the value?
L1 21.96
meters. L2 38.08. yes, once you get, no, you substitute and get L2, but also to cross check, total L minus this would be L2, because L1 plus L2 should be 60, no? So total L 60 minus this would also give me L2. You can cross-check always, cross-verify your answers whether what your substitution is right or wrong. Okay, so we found the values of L1 and L2. So once we find the values of L1 and L2, what is the next step? We can go ahead with
reactions.
Taking the reactions, yes. Second, reactions. So when we solve for reactions, I have to write summation f of y first, which is equal to 0. VA plus VB minus 1 kilonewton point load minus 0.0075 acting for 60 meters. Correct? UDL. So I'll have VA plus VB minus 1 minus 0.0075 into 60 equal to 0. What is VA plus VB you're getting?
0.0075 into 60 plus 1 1.45.
Yes, 1.45. Yeah, correct. Right. Okay. Now let us take moments. So moment at C, left hand side, let us consider. Okay. So I have to take moment at this point, assuming this is 5, and left hand side, meaning all the forces of this side. So what all will come? VA into L1. Okay. H into 5. H into 5 goes minus. VA into L1 goes plus. And then 0.0075 into this L1, into L1 by 2, and 1 into total L1 minus 20. Correct? So I'll start writing it. Firstly, VA into L1. I will write in terms of L1. This is positive because it goes in clockwise. VA goes to C in clockwise. Then minus H goes to C in anticlockwise. So minus H into this distance, that is 5. Minus H into 5. Then UDL. UDL is acting throughout. So minus 0.0075 into L1 is the load into L1 by 2 because it is movement. Okay, and it goes in anticlockwise, so it is minus. And then lastly, minus this 1 kilonewton. Okay, 1 kilonewton is acting at a distance of 20 meter. And this is our L1. So 1 into this distance I want. So this is going to be L1 minus 20. So 1 kilonewton into L1 minus 20 is equal to 0. So this is your equation. Any doubt with this? Any doubt? So we will substitute VA into L1. L1, how much we got? 21.96. Yes, it is more. The L1 is more than this. So 1 kilonewton is falling within only, right? Then minus H into 5 minus 0.0075 times of L1 is 21.96 into 21.96 divided by 2 minus 1 into 21.96 minus 20 equal to 0. Solve for this. This is going to be 21.96 times of VA minus 5 times of H. Let us substitute this. Minus 0.0075 into 21.96 into half of 21.96 again. So that is minus 1.808. And here this is going to be 21.96 minus 20 into 1, that is directly 1.96 equal to 0. So this, when I add plus 1.808, it becomes 3.76. So VA would be, these all will go on that side. So this becomes 3.768 plus 5H divided by 21.96. It's not visible. You should tell me it is not visible, madam. Okay. So, I took this numbers. I got a value 1.808. On calculating this, it is 1.96. These both are minus. So, I add them. They go to the other side and they become 3.768. This 5 goes to the other side. It becomes plus 5H. And VA I want. So, this 21 will come in the bottom. Similarly, we have to take moments. Moment at C from RHS side now, right hand side. So when I'm taking right hand side, there is no point load, only UDL will come into picture. It is going to be VB into L2, H into H2, that is 15. Okay, this H is positive, VB is negative, and then you have 0.075 acting for L2, that is 38 by L2 by 2. Okay, so I will write this RHS minus VB into L2, okay, minus VB into L2, then we have plus H into 11 because this distance, not 11, 15, sorry, H into 15. So I will write here minus H, plus H into 15. Then this UDL, when I'm taking moment, it is giving a clockwise moment, right? So plus, point, you can see the board, 0.0075 into L2 into L2 by 2 equal to 0. No other forces are there. There is no point load. Substitute here. Minus VB into L2 is 38.08 plus 15 times of H plus 0.0075 into 38.08 into 38.08 divided by 2 equal to 0. Solve for this now. So VB and this will come on the other side. So here it will be 15 times of H plus 0.0075 into 38.08 into half of 38.08. Okay, that is 5.45, this entire thing. This will remain as it is. This is VB into. So VB will be equal to this divided by 38.08. So you have a VB and VA equation. So what is your final? You know that VA plus VB is equal to 1.45 kilonewton. So substitute 3.76 plus 5H divided by 21.96 plus VB, 15H plus 5.45 divided by 38.08 is equal to 1.45. Can you please get me the value of H now? Let's see. Right. I give you only 2 minutes to try.
One point eight two.
You're getting kilonewton. Anybody else tried? 1.82 is right. SVB. We don't have the solution. I think 1.82. So once we get H, what is the next step? After getting the value of H, I did my result. What is the next thing what we do? We have to find VA and VB, right? So VA would be, which is 1.82. So 3.76 plus 5 times of 1.82, that is H, divided by 21.96 is your VA value. How much is VA? VB would be 15 times of H. How much?
0.585.
585 kilonewtons. Okay, VB is 15 times of H, that is 1.82, plus 5.45 divided by 38.08. Is to
Two point five zero.
How? This plus this should be 1.45, no?
Either the 0.86.
2 point. You're getting 2 point. See, your VA plus.
No, ma'am. 0.86.
0.86. You're getting. 0.86 plus 0.585. 1.45. This must be right. Check once again, okay? The one who gave me 2.5 value. But check madri. Because VA plus VB is 1.45. So I should get both same. Now they've asked us which point tension is more, either A or B. Directly I cannot take tension at B is maximum. So let us find tension at A. Tension at A is going to be what? VA square plus H square. Under root. Correct? So we will find the value of that. It is under root 0.585 square plus H is 1.82 square. Okay. And then find tension at B, that is VB square plus H square. Okay. VB is 0.86 square plus 1.82 square. You get the value of tension here. What is tension at 8?
1.911
kilonewtons. Okay, and TA, what is tension at B?
2.01
kilonewtons. Correct. Therefore, which is maximum? T max equal to TB, which is 2.01 kilonewton. Clear? It asks you to find where is the tension for. Okay. And if it is, I want you to find the length of the cable. We can do, no, we have directly the equation. If I ask you to find the length of the total cable, what is the equation? Total length of the cable L is given by L plus 2/3 of H1 square by L1 square plus H2 square by L2 square. So L is 60, that is span is 60. 2 by 3 of H1 means it is, H1 is how much? 5, correct. Pi square divided by L1 is 21.96 square plus H2 is 15 square divided by L2 is 38.08 square. So you get the total length. This is what? This is length of cable. Please find this also. If length of cable is asked, 5 square divided by 21.96 square plus 15 square divided by 38.08 square. This is done. Into 2 third plus 60. You get 60.138 meters. If they ask length of the cable, you will use this equation. Here in this, when supports are at different edge, actually it is very easy because you have direct equation for length, you have equations for L1, you have equations for H, everything. Then, but only is finding the moment is important. All of you can, understood any doubts? No doubts?